What's going on, guys, and welcome to another Reputized video. Escape Room is the first horror movie to be released this year, and last year was Insidious: The Last Key, which was not bad at all, and is done by the same director who did that film, believe it or not. And this film follows six strangers who gets invited to this escape room and is promised $10,000 if they survive. Escape rooms are a big thing right now. They have a Harry Potter themed one. They have a Star Wars themed one. And it was only a matter of time before they made a movie of it. In this film, they take what's a good and fun experience and turn it into something lethal and deadly. And the whole time I was watching it, I was thinking of Saw. Only this is a much, much less gorier version of that film. They find all these traps and clues and they try to survive at all costs. And they have different traps for each room. And I thought it was written very well. It was a very intriguing story. The only thing I couldn't get into was the characters. Most of them were dicks. Most of them were assholes. And I'm sorry to say that, but it was true. There's actually a line that one of the guys says in the movie where he actually says, it's like I'm playing the most funnest game with the most meanest people. The main character, played by Taylor Russell, I didn't feel like she brought anything new to the table. The more she showed up on screen, it just took me out of it. The more most of all of the other characters showed up on screen, I really couldn't get into them. They annoyed me. There's probably a couple of characters that I found that I did care about, but they took me out of the movie and they were pretty annoying. So yeah, you have gadgets and gadgets, you have puzzles, you have keys that you gotta unlock certain doors in time before like a room explodes or is on fire or something, and it's just all these different crazy type scenarios. My favorite one was by the time they got to the third room, and it was the upside down room. Everything looked like it was upside down. The camera would shift all the way upside down, and they would look like they were standing on the ceiling. And I thought that was a really good, really cool illusion. I really did enjoy that one. This movie had a lot of tensity in it. It was very gripping on the edge of your seat, and I did find it enjoyable. The other downer is the ending. Without giving anything away, it was a downer, and if this movie makes enough money at the box office, studios execs at Sony will most likely greenlight a movie. I really don't feel confident that the sequel will go theatrical. It'll probably be like released straight to DVD or something like that. And even if it does get released in theaters, I really do believe that it won't be with the same characters and it won't be as good. But I really do believe that this movie will make a sequel if the money talks. But this movie was really interesting and it had a lot of elements that Saw did. The only difference is much less gore. This film is rated PG-13. Adam Robitel did a really good job, just like he did with Insidious: The Last Key last year. I really did enjoy this movie, just like I did with that film. And I'm looking forward to more of his stuff in the future. I really do think he's a really talented filmmaker, and I'm looking forward to more of his stuff. This film was real watchable, and I really do think you'll get a big kick out of it. The story, the score, the music, the cinematography, the lighting, the editing was done really well. I do recommend this film. It did feel very Saw-like. For all you Saw fans out there, if you're expecting a lot of gore, you won't get it in this. This is PG-13, and you can bring pretty much the entire family or whoever enjoys a good horror intensity film, which is basically what this was. It wasn't about the gore at all. It was more about the intensity than anything else. Guys, Escape Room gets a B-. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this review. I really do appreciate it. Like, subscribe, get reputized. Make sure to subscribe to The Reactor, Reactions Galore, which is down the link down in the description below. And I should apologize in advance. I hadn't done any videos in that in a while. I've just been so busy with other stuff, but I will get on top of that soon, I promise. And also, make sure to look it up on Facebook, The Ripster, and The Reactor as well, which is also down in the link in the description below. What did you guys think of Escape Room? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Leave me a comment down below and let me tell me what you think. Stay tuned for more reviews coming soon. Peace, the Rep out.